In this session, we will be talking about the reports that you can download on a self-service basis in the Equinix customer portal. I will be touching on three main points in this session. The first point being where you can navigate to in order to access the reports, your reports. And next, the type of reports that you can find in the reports center. And lastly, how to generate one-time and recurring reports. So in order to navigate to the report center in the Equinix customer portal, navigate to the report main menu item and click on the report center submenu item. Once you land on this page, you will be able to see the list of reports that you can download from the Equinix customer portal. So I will be going through the list, this list from top down and left to right, and giving you an overview of the reports that are available. Firstly, the orders reports. So for orders report, this will show you all the orders that are placed within a given period. And for a user to access this report, they do not require any special permissions. Any user who has a Equinix customer portal account will be able to access this report. Next, the install-based report. In order to see this install-based report card appearing in the report center, a user will require the install-based permission being assigned to them by their admin. The install-based report shows the install base or your assets, including your cages, cabinets, power, cross connects, and your interconnection assets. Next, the order notification report. A user will not require any special permission to be assigned to them in order to see this report appearing in the report center. The order notification report shows all notifications for the orders during a particular period. Next, the IBX Network and Managed Services notifications. A user would require the IBX Services notifications permissions to be assigned to them before they are able to see this tile or this card appearing in the report center. And this report will show all the maintenance notification during a given time period. Next, the user details report. In order to see this report available in the report center, the user will be required to be an administrator user role type, as well as the manage user permission assigned to them. And by generating this report, it will show you your users and the access permissions assigned to them. Next, the user audit report. Similar to the user details report, a particular user will be required to be an administrator and have the manage user permission assigned to them before they can see this card appearing in the report center. Generating this report will show the trail of changes that were made to your users. Next, the Smart Hands Power Consumption Report. In order to view this card, a user will be required to have the order Smart Hands permission assigned to them. And note that this is a billable report, meaning to say, it is not a self-service generated report. But when you place a request for this report, it will be sent to Equinix as an order, and our ops team will be preparing the report before sending it over to you. Now, when we generate this report, it will show you the power consumption by cage, cabinet, or circuit. Next, the occupied ports report. In order to view this card in the report center, a user will be required to have the order cross-connect and intra-facility cables permission assigned to them. This report will show a summary of the port usage by patch panel. Next, the IBX visit log. In order to view this report, a user will first have to be an administrator and have the manage user permission assigned to them. And by generating this report, it will show the list of visitors who have signed in with the physical security at the IBX. Next, the IBX access activity report. In order to view this report in the report center, the user will be required to have the order smart hands permission report. And note that similar to the smart hands power consumption report, the IBX access activity report is available report. And when you generate this report, it will show you the list of visitors who have accessed your cage and when. Next, the IBX access permissions report. This is also a billable report, and in order to view this card in the report center, the user will be required to have the order smart hands permission assigned to them. By generating this report, you will be able to see the list of contacts who have permissions to access your space. Now that we have covered the types of reports available in the ECP Report Center, I'm going to show you how you can generate a report, and in particular, how to generate a recurring report. So using the install base report as an example, when we click through, you will see that there are some filters that are relevant for this particular report. And you can check on those checkboxes to perform a filtration for your report. What I want to bring your attention to is the date range and delivery option. So under date range, when you're generating a report, and if you see this date range option, clicking on the dropdown will show you the past date range where you can filter your report with. So these are the options available for you: the past 1 day, past 7 days, past 14 days, past 30 days, 90 days, 180 days, and to the maximum limit of the past 1 year. In addition to the date range, there is an optional setting called the recurrence option. And by selecting the recurrence, you are essentially generating a report automatically based on the option you selected. So if you select every day, you will be able to automatically get this report generated for you on a daily basis. And the other options available for you are every 7 days, every 30 days, every 90 days, and annually. So I'm going to show you an example of how we can generate a recurring report by selecting the annual option, the annually option. So once you have completed your filtration options and you have selected your date range and delivery, click on the generate report button located at the bottom right. Once you have generated that report, you will be brought to the manage reports tab. Now, the manage reports tab is for you to manage your recurring reports. And over here, you will see several options. The top, in the data grid on the top left, if you select that checkbox, it essentially selects all your recurring reports that you have created, and you have the option to delete all of them at one go. However, if you choose not to use the checkbox, you can still check one checkbox by itself and select the delete option. Now, apart from checking this checkbox, you have some more options, or rather actions, at the rightmost column in the data grid. So you have three options: generate, edit, or delete. By clicking on generate, you would request the report to be generated immediately in this particular moment, despite the fact that the recurrence option is on an annual basis. By clicking on edit, you will be able to edit the recurrence option in the report. And finally, by clicking on delete, you will be able to delete the recurring report, which is similar to the delete button over here. So in order to access your reports and download the Excel output, you have to go to the My Reports tab. Alternatively, you can go to the Reports main menu item and click on the My Reports submenu item. So over here, you will see a list of reports that you have generated in up to the past 7 days. Reports that are aged 7 days or older will be automatically deleted, and you will have to regenerate them again. And you will see the line over here, install base, which is the most recent report we downloaded. The status is in progress. That means to say the backend services are preparing your report, and once it's ready, you will be able to download it. How do you tell it's ready? Once the report is ready, you will be able to see that the download button has been activated and you can click on the download link. But if it's not ready, you will not be able to click on the download link. And you will also be able to delete the report if you no longer need it and you want to delete it before the 7 days period is up. And that sums up this walkthrough today. I hope you enjoyed the session. Thank you.